I just come from the media expert session on the issue of frailty in multiple myeloma. The question, of course, is there an issue of frailty in multiple myeloma? Because we do know that also the elderly patients with an age over 75 do benefit from the novel agents. We know that from several trials in newly diagnosed multiple myeloma patients, but also in relapsed refractory multiple myeloma patients. But I do think we do have an issue, because when you look to the outcome of these patients, progression-free survival might be similar, but overall survival is not. And that is probably because the toxicity of the first-line treatment prevents patients getting a second-line treatment or a third-line treatment. So therefore, their overall survival is less. So therefore, I think we really should look to who is frail. And we're grateful to the enormous efforts of the Italian group developing the International Myeloma Working Group Frailty Score, showing that frail patients experience more non-hematological toxicity, have to discontinue therapy more often, and therefore have less overall survival. But we also know, and also the Italian group do know that, and are also trying to refine the frailty score, because especially for patients over 75 who are by definition unfit, there might be fit and frail patients in the patients with an age between 75 and 80. So we're really looking for refinement of the frailty score. And we do not know exactly how to do. The German study group have tried to do so by implementing renal function, by implementing pulmonary function, but still they're also in their score, there's a subjective character in defining the overall frailty, which is also in their frailty assessment. Another way to go is to maybe simplify it and maybe even make it more easy in general practice. And that is what the French group has been investigating. So they changed the ADL and the IADL to the EQ5D, which is just five questions. And what they found is that also using this EQ5D instead of ADL and instrumental EDL, the frail patients did worse. And we in the Netherlands investigated in the HOVON 123 trial the impact of the WHO instead of ADL and IADL, and it's not published yet. We hope to present at ASH, but also we see that the WHO really is able to differentiate between the outcome of frail and fit patients. So in conclusion, we have a very good frailty score. There should be refinement, so we're looking for novel markers, and maybe we can even make it more simpler, more simple. The novel markers, one additional remark on that, so we're now only looking to questionnaires, but also functional assessments might be of interest. So looking at grip strength, the walking speed, and looking with CT scans to sarcopenia, and we're investigating that now. So now you have your frailty score, and what then? How to implement in clinical practice? We don't have yet clinical studies, the outcome of clinical studies, in which there was a frailty assessment, and then the dose was adapted according to the frailty assessment. But the British Myeloma group has now been developing a clinical study. So they do a frailty assessment, and then they close their eyes in half of the patients and just give their treatments. And in the other half of the patients, they dose adjust the therapy. So we're really awaiting these trials. We in the Netherlands are doing a study within only frail and only unfit with ixazomib and daratumumab to see how feasible that is. Until the results of that studies are available, in clinical practice we can use the frailty score, because we know that when we look to frail patients, you should give a less intense induction therapy, because otherwise they have to discontinue therapy and have a worse outcome. So we showed in the HOVON study that when you give less induction therapy, and the PETIMA showed that when you continue with maintenance therapy, that your outcome is better than, by example, in the VISTA trial. Not head-to-head compared, but we know that's feasible, and also for treatment with lenalidomide dexamethasone, you probably have to adjust the dose, and there are expert opinions on that that have been published. But lastly, the future. What will the future bring? I think we will have to look at the biology of aging. We know that the epigenome is very important, and that affects the inflammatory environment, senescent cells, proteostasis. So in the future, hopefully, we will be able to intervene, so we understand and then intervene in order to improve the outcome of frail and unfit patients with multiple myeloma.